He said, see, Bhagavan Pārtha, the personality of God is speaking. Now, Sri Krishna answering, the symptoms of the self-realized personality. So, what is that first symptom is, prajahati jada kaman sarvan partho manogatan atmani eva atmana tushta sthita pragnasta duchyati. The first principle of the first symptom of a self-realized soul is that he does not make any plan for his prosperity. Because we are always busy in making plans. Now, after this, we shall do this. But one who is self-realized, he has no plan, because he has dovetailed himself with the Supreme Consciousness, so for himself he has nothing to do. He simply depends. He simply depends on the Supreme Consciousness. It is very elevated state, you see, that completely he surrenders himself. And but we should not be, imitating this. This is, of course, spoken for the highest stage. But we should, without coming to that highest stage, we should not imitate. When Krishna is asked, he must give the proper answer. So he is giving the answers that prajahati jata kaman sarvan partha manogata. Because our mind is the factory of creating so many plans. But one who has dovetailed himself, he has nothing to do for plan making, because everything is taken up by the Supreme Consciousness. He has simply to follow. Therefore, he has, for himself, he has no plan. This is the first step. But and without reaching that stage, and we should not pose ourselves that I have nothing to think, I have nothing to think of future, past, or everything. No, gradually we shall come to the stage when there will be everything done automatically. In the present moment, we should give up plan making, but we shall have to take up the plan of the Supreme Consciousness. Personally, we shall not make any plan, but we have to receive the plans from the Supreme Consciousness. That will be our position. Just like an apprentice, he is working. In the apprenticeship, he should not present his own plan, but he has to take plans of work from his superior. Then he will learn. And when he is accustomed, when he is elevated, then he will be able to make independent plans, not independent always, but even if he is higher officer, everyone has to consult the higher authority. Similarly, this means that I shall not independently make any plan, but I must accept the standard plan and which is coming directly from the Supreme Consciousness through a channel. We have to seek that channel. So that channel is called, you will find it in the Bhagavad Gita, in the fourth chapter, parampara. Parampara, disciplic succession. The words, the plans, and the instruction which is coming directly from Krishna, that thing we have to accept. We shall not make any our own plan. That is the way of making progress. Now, this disciplic succession, as we have accepted, this disciplic succession comes from Krishna. Just like Krishna is instructing Arjuna. Krishna is instructing Arjuna. And we have to understand how Arjuna has understood Krishna. And if we follow the understanding of Arjuna, then we are following the parampara system or the disciplic succession. That is the process. Now in the 10th chapter, you will find that how Krishna is understood by Arjuna. After hearing at least 75% of the instruction of Bhagavad Gita, the estimation of Arjuna is stated in the 10th chapter. He says that, Arjuna, after understanding Krishna, after his instruction, he says that automatically he says, Parang Brahma Parang Dhamma Pavitram Paramam Bhavan Purusam Sasatam Dibbam Adi Devam Ajang Vibhum. Krishna, now I understand it that you are Param Brahma. Param Brahma means the supreme spiritual identity. Every one of us is Brahma. You are Brahma, I am Brahma. Every living entity is Brahma. Because he is not this matter, he is spirit, soul. Whoever he is spirit, soul, he is called Brahma. But Krishna is addressed here, Param Brahma. Just like we recited that sloka, the verse, Ishara Parama Krishna. Ishara, every one of us, Ishara, the translation of Ishara word is God. Now God means, Ishara means controller. So every one of us is controller. But Krishna is the supreme controller. He has no controller. I am controller. I am Brahma. But at the same time, I have got superior controller over me. But Krishna is called Param Brahma or the Ishara Parama, the supreme controller, because he has no controller over me. That is the acceptance of Arjuna. This is the mode of studying Bhagavad Gita. If we don't interpret in our own way, if we really want to study Bhagavad Gita, then here is the confirmation by Arjuna, how he understands Krishna after hearing Bhagavad Gita. Not only that, he also, in the 11th chapter, you'll find that Arjuna will request Krishna to show him his gigantic universal form. Because he, Arjuna as he is, he accepted Krishna that he is God undoubtedly. But in future, people may think that Krishna and Arjuna were two friends. So out of friendly appreciation, Arjuna might have accepted Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But what is the evidence to us? Now here, when Krishna, Arjuna requested that, Krishna, you kindly show me the gigantic form, the gigantic universal form, he showed. That is also described. So the idea is that imitation God, there may be so many. Nowadays it has become a fashion, not in your country, at least in India, it has become a fashion that everyone is coming out and he declares himself, I am God. I am God. As if the God has become a very cheap thing and it can be had in the market wherever you go. That is not the thing. God is not so cheap thing, you see. God is not so cheap thing. The description of God is in the Brahma Sanghita is given. Jasai kanishasita kalam athavalam jivanti loma vilaja jagadannanatha Vishnu mahan sayajas kalavisisu govindamadi purusam tamaham bhajami. The gods, this material creation, we have got this information from authoritative scripture. This material creation, how it is being done? It is being done that the Supreme Lord, in His form of Mahavishnu, is lying on the causal ocean and in a sleeping mode, and with the breathing of His nostril, so many universes are being born as seed. And when He is taking the breathing, inhaling, the whole thing is going into Him. So such is the position of God, that by His breathing, all the universes are coming, and by His breathing, so the existence of this universe means within His breathing period, within the breathing period of the Mahavishnu. So that Mahavishnu is described, jasai kanishasita kalam athavalamba jivanti loma vilaja jagadannanatha Vishnu mahan sayajas kalavisasa. That Mahavishnu is also plenary portion of Krishna, Govinda. That Mahavishnu is also not the original. The original personality of God is Krishna. So, this is a great science, what Krishna is, Krishna science. It is simply a synopsis. Bhagavad Gita is only a synopsis of the science of God. And it is more explicitly given in the Srimad Bhagavat. But after all, it is a great science. And if we study it very seriously, then we can understand. We should not take so cheaply that here is a God, here is a God, here is a God. No, no, God is not so cheap. God is one, and He is great. God is great, as in English language it is said. And nobody can be greater than Him or equal to Him. That is the position of God. Now here, Arjuna, he accepts Krishna, and he says that you are Parabrahma. Parabrahma, Param Dhamma. Dhamma means in which everything rests. We are resting. Everything is resting, just like this is scientific and practical, you know, that the innumerable planets that you can see at night as luminary stars in the sky, each and every one of them, more or less, they are all different kinds of planets. But do you know how they are floating in the space? They are floating on the sun sign, on the sun rays. They are floating, that you can see. Similarly, the sun sign is the imitation of the Brahma Jyoti that is coming out of the body of the Supreme Lord. So everything is resting on the sign of the Supreme Lord. Therefore He is called Param Dhamma. Param Dhamma means everything resting on you. Param Brahma, Param Dhamma, Pavitram. Pavitram means uncontaminated. Because we, although we are Brahma, now we are contaminated by this material body. But the Lord has no contaminated body of this material existence. We have already noted, Ishara Paramakrishna Sachidananda Vigraha. Sachidananda Vigraha means His body is full of bliss, full of knowledge, and it is eternal. That is completely distinct from this body. So when there is description of the Lord that He is formless. He is formless means He is not of this form. He has got a Sachidananda Vigraha, a different element. Therefore He is called Pavitra. And Paramam Bhama, you are the supreme original. Purusam Shasatam Divyam Adi Devam Ajan Vibhum. So you are Purus. Purus means enjoyer. In the Vedic literature, about yourself, Ahustam Rishayo Sarve, all the greatest sages accept you, the Supreme Lord. Ahustam Rishayo Sarve, Devarsi Narada, Devarsi Narada. I have already spoken to you about Narada. He has also accepted. That means authorities. He is quoting authorities. Not that. I am personally accepting you as such. But there are many authorities. Many authorities. So we have to understand about the science of God from the extraordinary activities and confirmed by the authorities, accepted by the revealed scriptures, then we have to accept, you see. Not blind. So Arjuna is giving such evidences, you see. Asito devala vyasa sanchaiva bravisime. You are accepted by such authorities like that, and I have the opportunity that I hear all these from you directly. I am fortunate enough that I am become your related in friendship with you, and I am hearing. So here is the evidence. Now, if you want to study Bhagavad Gita, then you have to accept all these statements of Arjuna. Because Bhagavad Gita was explained directly to Arjuna. And if you don't accept the appreciation of the direct person who heard Bhagavad Gita, then whom do you believe? Suppose I have heard something directly from one person, so what I am saying, another person who has no direct relation, he is also saying, whom would you believe? You have to believe the person who has directly heard. So here, there is no doubt about it, that Arjuna directly heard Krishna, and his appreciations are recorded here. So therefore, if we want to study Bhagavad Gita, then we have to accept the appreciation of the direct here, Arjuna. If you do that, then we can get the right thing. But if we change it for our ulterior motive, as so many annotators are doing in the case of Bhagavad Gita, then we shall not be able to understand what is Bhagavad Gita. All right. Let us have some questions here.